Hi, we are seeing the continuation of last session. This is problem number 21. This is a given circuit. You have to find out the current in this circuit. So there are three voltage sources and there are two resistors. You have to find out what is the current in that. Very simple, you have to apply the KVL. So if you apply the KVL, then this is from drop to rise. So I have written plus 2. Similarly, this is also from drop to rise, again 3. Plus 3, then this is minus 5i. This is from drop to raise. So this is plus 2.5. This is minus 5i, which is equal to 0. Then if you simplify this, then 10i, which is equal to 1.5, then I equal to 1.5 divided by 10. You can do it in another method also. You can just simply do like last problem. You can just simplify this. 2 plus, then 2 minus 3, and this is plus 2.5. if you just add all this, then you will be getting 1.5, and then you can just simply add these two, because these two resistors are in series. Then you can find the current also by simplifying the circuit. Also you can find, you can just do like using KVL also. Next is find current I from this circuit. Same like that, this is the circuit. I have just made a plus minus in signs. You can apply KVL. So this is plus 5 minus 3i, then this is plus minus 2 plus, so I have written plus 6 minus 3i. This is plus 2 minus, so minus 3. This is minus 3i. This is minus 2 plus, so plus 4. This is minus 3i. If you simplify this, you will be getting 12i is equal to 12, then I equal to 1 ampere. Instead of this, you can add 3 plus 3, 3 plus 3, 3 plus 3. So 3 into 4, 12. So that is 12i, it is written. You can just add, this is plus 5. 5 plus 6, 5 plus 6, 11. This is minus 3. So 11 plus 11 minus 3, it is again 8. So 8 plus 4, 8 plus 4 is 12. So you have got 12 here. You can just do simplify this circuit, and you can write directly also from the circuit. I will show you few more example how to reduce this circuit into simple form, and then you will understand. Then you have to find V1 and V2. So how to find V1 and V2? If two voltages are connected in series, you can use the voltage divider rule. So this is R1, this is R2, so 5 ohm and 15 ohm. So voltage divider rule, according to voltage divider rule, if you want to find out the V1, V1 is equal to V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. This is the voltage divider rule which we have seen in the last video. We have seen voltage division. If three resistors are connected like this, so this is the formula which we have derived: V1 equal to V into R1 by R1 plus R2 plus R3. Similarly, there are two resistors which is connected in series. So we are writing V into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So here, according to this, this is the 10. Just substitute the value. This is V, source voltage, then R1 divided by R1 plus R2. You are getting this value. Similarly, V2 formula is V into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So just substitute that same values, V into R divided by, you will be getting 7.5. Next is find I1 and I2. So from this circuit, you have to find what is I1 and I2. This, if you look at this, this is current divider rule. So for current divider rule, you know the formula. So I have taken what is I1 and what is I2. This is the I value. So I equal to 2 ampere. This is R1, this is R2. So according to the current divider rule, you know I1 is equal to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is the formula. So just substitute the value I into R2. So R2 is 10, I is 2. So 2 into 10 divided by 5 plus 10, you will be getting 4 by 3. and I2 is equal to I into R1 divided by R1 plus R2. So 2 into 5 divided by R1 plus R2 is equal to, you will be getting 2 by 3. So few more problem we will be seeing. We will see in next video. Thank you.